Hey everyone, Matt here with more Legend of Zelda, Breath of the Wild, picking up where we left off. The flight range here. And we're down. Alright, luckily there's like a constant gust. Alright, here we go. Flew right past him.
Yeah? I don't know you, and I'm actually pretty busy here. You should probably go.
That's it. Did you need something? I'm busy here. I can help you. Mm-hmm. Help me? What exactly? Long Meadow. Let me get this straight. Samanda Mahalian wants to help me bring down Divine Beast Va Meto. I'm not buying it. What's your name, stranger? Link. Link, huh? Well, Link, I'm Tiba, but you already knew that. Guessing the Elder asked you to come here and talk some sense into me, am I right? Yeah, that's true. Just like the Elder to trust any old fool wandering into town. Look, you seem like an alright guy, but let's make one thing clear. I'm not going anywhere. As a Rito warrior, I can't rest until my people are safe. There's only one way I'm going back to Rito Village. That is, once Divine Beast Va Meto falls from the sky. If I have to kill Meto, so be it. Only then will I return to the village. Let's get started. Are you serious? Ha! Well, far be it for me to talk you off the ledge. But it's as the Elder said. The only way to stop Divine Beast Va Meto is to get inside it. Fat chance of that happening. There's no way we can set foot in Meto. Actually. Not only are you wingless, you're brainless, too. Let me fill you in, the only people able to enter the Divine Beast are the five champions of old. Unfortunately for us and the rest of Hyrule, they all died 100 years ago. If it hadn't been for Ganon. Never mind, let's focus on bringing down Meto, one step at a time. If we approach Meto recklessly, its cannons will blast us out of the sky before we even get close. So I'm gonna need to test you before I take you with me. We Rito warriors use the updraft in this ravine to hone our aerial archery skills. The updrafts are so strong here that a person could just open up a cloth over their head and float up easily. Well, let's see what you're capable of. You'll have to maneuver through the air and destroy 5 of the targets set up in this valley in 3 minutes. Yeah. Using a bow in midair is just like using a bow on the ground. But you'll probably want a bow suited for long range engagement. Use your arrows to destroy 5 targets in 3 minutes. If you can't do that, you don't stand a chance against Meta. Are you ready to be tested? Nope. Then go destroy 5 targets with your arrows. Oh, there we go. Oh, okay, cool. It'll give me back my stamina.
Keep it up. That's it.
Let's go long range on this one. Ah, shit. Okay, come on back. Alright, that wasn't too bad. When I tried to do this on my own, my stamina would... It did not refill. I just came in here, like, I just happened to cross it, and I just was curious, so I went to go shoot a target I missed, and my stamina ran out. And then I fell to my death in this pit. You're a skilled archer. It was as if time stopped with every arrow you let fly. Gotta tell you, Link. First showed up, I thought someone was pulling a prank on me. But after seeing you handle that bow, I can tell you the real deal. You must have seen a battle with hundreds, I believe. Let me bring down its cannons, all you got. Inside that treasure chest is a bow I've modified. Take it and let me know when you're ready. Alright, cool, I got one for one. Falcon bow, quick shot. Might as well. It's weaker, and if I'm going to be breaking anything, I'm going to be using the arrows a lot. Or, well, no, I guess just the one other that I'm going to be using. Let's go ahead and save, though. Okay, it's time to face Divine Beast Bob Meadow. Normal arrows won't put a dent in those cannons. You'll need to hit them with bomb arrows. These are a precious commodity, so don't expect me to do this again, but take these bomb arrows. Times 20, alright. Also, it'll be cold up there. You want to prepare a warm meal or bring some warm clothes. Ready? Alright, let me ask you something. Why are you doing this? Why risk your life to bring down Meadow? I can't just watch. You can't just sit and watch innocent people be terrorized. Imagine how I feel as a proud Rito warrior. That's fair enough. Right, get on. Showtime! Oh, jeez. Man, even I feel like I'm gonna freeze up here. Well, I'm all good. I got my cold gear on. There's Divine Beast Bob Meadow. Has his barrier up again. What a pain. What's wrong, Link? Too scared to talk? Let's go over the plan. You see those cannons? I'll draw their fire. While I'm doing that, use your bomb arrows to destroy the cannons. Got it so far? You need to withdraw for a bit, just spread your cloth and float straight up in the updraft for a while. Take that as a sign that we need to regroup. Don't bother aiming for anything covered by a Meadow's barrier, it's impenetrable. Whatever you do, don't get close enough to touch it. And finally, I know I've said this a few times already, but don't forget your cold protection. You can move whenever you're ready. Let's go. I'm ready for this. Now go blow up those cannons.
You got it.
Nope. Drop. Oh, that was close. Has oddly given me a lot more control than the other two did. Granted, you know, Prince Zidon was a very competent swimmer. Can't say the same about my Saiyan sequel. Or maybe Regis Saiyan still? Not even certain exactly. It's a very Star Wars feel to the music right now. What happened if I touch it? A little curious. Uh-oh. Drop. It's good that it refills my stamina, though. Yeah, but yeah, this would be like impossible otherwise. Especially if you only had one stamina wheel. Alright! It was actually pretty easy. Still, it was fun. Totally badass.
Well done, Link. That thing is history.
Uh-oh. busted leg.
It looks like I got hit pretty good back there. I think I need to get back to the flight range. I just hope that I can make it back.
Oh.
You head down to Meadow.
Well, shouldn't be too bad. Just fall until you're close to the ground, then start flapping
it's
again.
All you.
I really don't like the way he phrased that. He's not a man of many words, but I like him. I don't want him to be dead. Honestly, I'm kind of surprised that the champions are dead, that they're just spirits now. Like, it's surprisingly dark. I mean, I know death is a thing in the Zelda games, but still, like, have these important characters that, like, basically begin the game dead. You know, not like this implied stuff with Majora's Mask, even though it's kind of disproven with Twilight Princess, about the whole death aspect of that game. Afterlife, or whatever the theory is.
Well, now, I've seen that face before.
Of course.
I had a feeling you would show up eventually, but making me wait 100 years is a bit indulgent.
Man, Revali's voice sounds really familiar to me.
You're here to wrest control of Meadow away from Ganon, correct? If so, then the first thing you'll want to do is find yourself a map.
Alright. Inside the head.
That so guidance stone like has eyes. The information for the layout of this divine beast. Can you make it there?
I like how he sounds a little condescending still. Like, obviously they've never patched things up in the end. The only other time we've even seen Revali is, was in that first memory that we found. Nothing out here. Anything down there? Probably not. No need to risk it. No need to waste those. Oh, shit. Just got me to start going towards that ledge. Wonder if I could have made that jump though. Probably not. I hope there's at least like 4 like moderately sized shrine dungeons. That'd be interesting. I mean, I've seen dungeons that have keys, but like, there's usually no more than one key. And while I'm sure leaving a shrine does not, like, I'm sure the key won't be able to be used in a different shrine, although with the way they're set up, it probably wouldn't be an issue with it. Oh, I probably need to be able to adjust the wings. I bet that's what it is. I bet that's the gimmick for this dungeon. We had the cylinders inside the camel's stomach, and then the trunk for the elephant. Ah, you're inside. If there were some sense of growth, though. Like, I mean, we're basically given these five right here, this is really not necessary, and, like, that's completely optional, so. Outside of a few trials, I have found, like, no conceivable use for stasis. And, like, optional stuff. Like, the rest of these do seem like they're required at one point or another. Shouldn't get this critical. Nope. Oh, getting too close, buddy. Come on. You've got to stop spazzing. There we go. It took five tries. Oh, I probably tilt the entire bird. I see that that's gonna make some of this get more difficult. Or actually no, because I can just change it at any time. Six. Oh, yeah, there's only three control points. Okay.
You'll need to look closely at your map of the Divine Beast. The terminals that will activate Meadow are marked by those glowing points. You'll need to activate all of the terminals to take back control. Think you're up to it.
A lot of room to fight the boss, at least. Oh, Thunderblight's probably gonna want to scurry around in there, though. Alright. Let's go ahead and do that. Oops. Well, I should be tilting my mat. Not gonna go too much. What can I take? Oh, the arrow. Close. Right up the edge. I saw stairs. Looks like you can. There's so much more visible cracks and stuff in there to climb up along than any mountain. Ah, okay. Oh, oh, it would have just gone all the way in. Well, that was dumb. I thought it stopped along like one of the rocks or something.
There are four terminals remaining. Still a ways to go.
Oh, yeah. That did it. There's one that I wonder if... Oh! Or something? That's a little silly.
There are three terminals remaining. Keep going.
Treasure chest. Yep. Looks like you're just gliding straight. That's the one I'm using now, isn't it? No, Falcon Bow. Let's see. How much is the Royal Bow? 38. Durability up. Oh, those are probably just there to... Yep. Is that actually a sniper bow, or is it just... No, it's just the aim bows. One of my arrows fall, like, right here. Ancient core. Not bad. Need those. Alright. Good thing's gonna be spitting them out. Yep. Wait, what was it? Oh, jeez. Oh, yes. I need that one. Oh, what do I want to give up? I haven't once used the Edge of Duality, so...
Two terminals remaining. You're almost there.
I don't know if that's supposed to be condescending surprise or actual surprise. Oh. There you go. Roll on in there. Oh, it's metal. Oh, okay, that's why those barriers are so bad. Video is running kind of long. I don't want to make it too long. It kills my upload, the upload times kill me. So yeah, we will go after the last terminal and then take on, I don't know, Windfly Blight Ganon. I don't know. We'll see. So until next time.